I just, dude, I can't get out of my head a cricket as Jack Bauer, where it's like cricket is 24 for just like one episode. Like, how amazing would that be? Like, because he's done 24 episodes, like cricket is Jack Bauer. And then you got Chloe, who's like Chloe's D, and she's like, cricket!
You know, Chloe's Gail the Snail, right? Chloe from 24 is Gail the Snail.
That's true. She literally is. Wow, way to tie it together. That's wild.
Hey-o!
If I go in the bathroom and smoke some PCP?
Nah, dude, you do you. We don't judge, Cricket. We don't judge.
Welcome to the Night Pod Cometh, where we talk about the legendary FX show, It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. I am Jamie G. Esquire, the fifth, master of the Lady and the Tramp move. And I'm here with Magnum Mills and the Soupdeucer to get even more hyped for season 16. It's coming. We're going to go ahead and rank our favorite cricket appearances. Yes, you heard it right. Let me say it again. We're getting ready to rank our favorite cricket appearances. You hit the jackpot. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for the intro, sir. I am Magnum Mills. This is the Night Pod Cometh. Find us wherever you get your pods, on YouTube, on social media, at Night Pod Cometh. And please don't forget the flaps. Follow, like, and please subscribe. Helps people find our show, find our channel. We greatly appreciate it. If you've had fun, just give us that thumb. That's all we ask. Soupdeucer, round us out, baby.
What's happening, everybody? I am the Soup. Welcome to the Night Pod Cometh. I am here on the Night Pod, man, doing the Night Pod thing. We're going to talk about some cricket, man. And I'm looking forward to talking about some fucking cricket.
Please be aware that not only is cricket in the scene, but this is a full-on spoiler show. So literally everything associated with Sunny, all episodes, the killer podcast, the interviews with the gang, it is all open for discussion here. This is your only warning, man. I'm not going to give it twice.
A, that's what she said. B.
Let's do this thing.
All right. You guys are going to love this. Cricket. One of the best characters ever, certainly one of our favorites on Always Sunny. He has appeared in 24 episodes. So, yes, we went ahead and ranked them from 1 to 24 based on how much we enjoyed Cricket. Not necessarily the episodes, but just this is Cricket-centric. So, Mills, well, he's a mathematician. He gathered the results and averaged them out to give us our rankings. Thank you, Magnum Mills. The world thanks you. And, my dude, go ahead, show us what you're working with. First, shake that ass.
I like the mystical reference. I just really like the cricket thing there. That was very solid. Starting at the bottom, we have The Gang Wins a Big Game. That's his 21st appearance, season 13, episode 9, at the bottom for all of us, basically. 23, Mac Finds His Pride. That's season 13, episode 10. 22, Charlie's Home Alone, season 13, episode 8. 21, D Gives Birth, season 6, episode 12. We had a three-way tie for 18 between The Gang Cracks the Liberty Bell, Psycho Pete Returns, and The Gang Goes on Family Fight. At 17, we have The Gang Tens Bar. 16, The Gang Exploits a Miracle. We had a two-way tie at 14 between Patty Says a Jumper and Pop Pop the Final Solution. We have a tie at 12 between and he made Smut Film. 11, we have Poop Poop the Bed. That brings us to the top 10. At number 10, we have The Gang Dances Their Asses Off. That's the third appearance by Rickety Cricket, season 3, episode 15. At number 9, we have Mac and Dennis Manhunters. This is the fourth appearance by Cricket, season 4, episode 1. We have a tie at number 7 between Mac's Big Break, Cricket's 8th appearance, season 6, episode 4, and The Janitor Always Mops Twice. That's Cricket's 23rd appearance, season 14, episode 6. At number 6, we have High School Reunion, his 11th appearance, season 7, episode 12. We have a tie at number 4 between PTSD, 17th appearance, season 12, episode 7, and A Cricket's Tale, 19th appearance, season 12, episode 9. At number 3, we have The Gang Squashes Their Beefs, 13th appearance, season 9, episode 10. Then we have a tie up top between The Gang Gets Whacked, part 2, his second appearance, season 3, episode 13, and The Gang Rustles for the Troops, his seventh appearance, season 5, episode 7. Tie at the top here, those two episodes in our top 10. Anybody want to defend The Gang Gets Whacked versus The Gang Rustles for the Troops? I will say I had The Gang Gets Whacked Part 2 as my favorite Cricket appearance. Just for him, when he gets into the drums and he's doing the cocaine and everything, I just loved that whole bit of it. And then the gang pins all everything, you know, the mobs, you know, they beat the shit out of Cricket. That's how he winds up at the exoskeleton for the gang, dances their asses off. Any thoughts on the top two here, The Gang Gets Whacked Part 2 or The Gang Rustles for the Troops as top Cricket appearance?
First of all, I agree with everything you said, and it's amazing. But when we go wrestles, okay, you got to understand, when this episode came out, this was peak Taliban, 9/11, hating like Middle Eastern people in America. Like, that was a thing in our country for a minute after 9/11. That's very close to when this aired. Like, it was still kind of raw, and they did this and they made him like the Taliban dude, but made it into a huge joke, and it was hilarious. And that was kind of not the first time, but kind of early on you saw Sonny's ability to do this and do it so well.
Soup, any thoughts on our tie for the top here?
Shit, you know what, man? I don't know. I was leaning in the other direction, but after that, I'm just convinced that this is probably a solid tie right here, man, you know? I am, however, a little disappointed that Cricket's Tale didn't tie for the first place.
Me too.
But, you know,
that was my first.
We're going to get to that in a minute here. I think the gang squashes their beasts. We are all pretty simpatico there. I had a 9, Jamie G 4, Soup 5, PTSD. I had a 4, Soup had a 4, Jamie G at 13. Cricket only has one appearance here, but it's as the Matthew McConaughey from Magic Mike stripper dude, where he just comes out in the vest with all the ringworm and the hair and the teeth and the chicks. I think that even though it's a very short appearance, I think it was very tops. Soup agreed. Why are you kind of low on that one?
Look, man, when you're ranking 24 of these, it gets tough, right? Somebody's got to be placed somewhere. For me, you're automatically knocked a couple of points just because it's just the cameo. You just get the one. And I think that was kind of a classic case here. You know, episodes that get more of Cricket for me tended to be higher on my rankings.
Fair enough. And tied with that, we have A Cricket's Tale at 4. Both of you had it at 1. I had it at 19. It's like, how could you have the most Cricket centric episode? Your thing there, Cricket centric. Actually, that's what Comedy Central should go to if they ever cross over with Animal Planet.
You gotta defend like that other shit, way. Dude. Like, what you like? I need like a defense here. I'm kind of insulted. Like, I feel hurt over this ranking of yours
because it's the quality of the Cricket, and I really enjoyed this episode. When I watch it, I can literally even tell you exactly when I watch it. But staying with my train of thought, it just killed me in the end. The idea that he's been on PCP for days with a dog. Cricket's not that dumb. We know, like, street urchin, yes. Sleazy, yes. That dumb, no. And they did it all just to get the payoff of the gag with him, like, kissing his dad's golden retriever, and it just wasn't enough. It was too far. Even the Great Lady in the Tramp gag couldn't save it for me. So, retroactively, that took down my enjoyment of the whole episode. And when I did watch it was somewhere where the power was out back in the day, watching it on my little-ass cell phone without unlimited data to try to watch it live. And I was looking forward to this episode so much, and it just didn't do it for me.
That's a bummer, man. I disagree. I respect your opinion, but I just... You get so much of Cricket. He's such a great character. For me, it had to be number one.
Yeah, I agree.
It's a good one, man. Number one. And I think it's kind of like, it makes you understand Cricket a little bit, right? I mean, like.
Yeah, well, you'll get a chance to come at me in a minute. We're all pretty simpatico on High School Reunion. And then we have the tie at 7. Max Big Break. Pretty close. The janitor always mops twice. Jamie G has a 2. Soup has a 3. I have it at 20.
Wow. All right. Defend that. Because obviously
there's not that much to it. I mean, it's the black and white, you know, it's the film noir joint. You got Cricket in drag or whatever with the cherries, and it's fine. I just don't think it's that consequential of an episode, and not, you know, and definitely not one of my favorite Cricket appearances. I mean, it's fine. It's just doesn't blow me away or anything. I like the episode itself. This is the case where I like the episode more than the Cricket appearance.
But Mills, did it blow you?
Let's go blow this guy
away. Blow this guy away.
Whatever.
We gotta hype up Demolition Man. We're getting ready to do that on Regular Dudes. Gotta hype it up. Go check out Regular Dudes Watch Stuff. We do cool shit over there too. But back to A Night Pod Cometh.
Jamie G, let's get to one that you were lower on than everybody else. 9 Mac and Dennis Manhunters, we're all pretty good with, but 10, the gang dances their asses off. Jamie G, you had it at 19, I had it 7. Soup 6, Cricket plays a big part in this episode. Why so low?
I don't know. I feel like this was at a point where like Cricket wasn't as awesome as he ended up being as a character. We get a bunch of them, but he's just not like it's so centered on like the whole competition thing. Like I just
still love for D. It's still when he was desperately in love with
yeah.
D,
it's just a little too early Cricket for me, for my like favorite version of Cricket. I need like Cricket who's been in like dog orgies and like has been smoking PCP. Like I need that version of Cricket. That's the wild crazy Cricket. This is still like the early Cricket. So that's why it was ranked a little bit lower for me. Very good episode. Enjoyed it. But that's why.
I guess we should know it probably gets bonus points from us because of the Tanya Hart and Nancy Kerrigan thing, right? Because we're of a certain age that we remember that. Where he comes in and he hits D in the knee. That is a very, very specific reference.
But it's a relevant reference for us. Like I remember that, dude. That was like the biggest story in the world at one point. Like that was a big deal, dude. Like, yeah. So I like that they threw that in.
I think there's two more notable ones to touch on before we get out of here. I think the first is the gang cracks the Liberty Bell. None of us were super high on it. I had it at 12, Jamie G 20, Soup 17. But for me, that is definitely an episode where I enjoy the Cricket appearance more than the episode. Not my favorite episode, but Cricket playing the rich British dude who like forgets to just tell D that he's rich and then gets his head blown off. I don't know. It's as far as a Cricket appearance, there's a lot of it. I think he's very funny and I think he adds to it. I like him better than the episode. So that's why I was kind of high on that one. Anybody have any thoughts on Cricket in Liberty Bell before we can move on?
I think that's hilarious because you literally fucking hate the gang cracks the Liberty Bell. It's probably your least favorite episode ever.
Dude, the Max Wooden teeth thing is just a little bit too much for me, man. That's definitely not one of my favorites.
But you know,
gags.
On rewatch though, it's not as bad as you think. I will say
that. Never been a bad episode of Sunny. I think we can stand by that. And I think the other one worth mentioning here is the gang exploits Miracle, Cricket's first appearance. Any thoughts on this one, really? Jamie G, you were by far the lowest at 22. I had 8, Soup 11. You didn't like the origin story?
I don't know, man. It's hard. I think this just fell victim of like placement.
Well, he's the least fun Cricket too in this one because he's just a straight Matthew. He's Matthew Moore, a priest. He's not even Cricket yet, really. I mean, they call him
right again. It kind of like when I'm ranking these things, like you guys have got to understand out there if you're listening in, like try to rank 24 of anything. Try to rank 24 beers. Go ahead and drink 24 beers and try to rank them. Like it takes a minute. It's a lot of thought. 24 of anything's a big number. This is Cricket. We love Cricket. There's a bunch of good shit in here. You start to get this log jam. All of a sudden, you're log jamming, dude. And it's like, you're in there with the thick of it when there's a bunch of them. For me, it's like, again, just boils down to not my favorite version of Cricket. So I had to kind of bump it down.
Well, dude, I'll totally agree with you on some of that. Where I ran into trouble differentiating kind of between fucking, you know, Cricket character or the strength of the episode. You know, so like some of these episodes I really liked, but it wasn't like the best Cricket performance, you know. I mean, most notably the fucking Charlie's Home Alone one, you know. I mean, that one that would have ranked a lot higher had Cricket played a bigger role in it other than just being Green Man, although he does rock Green Man pretty well, you know, and it's a real solid episode. But, you know, being that he only had that small bit, I had to knock it down on the scale there.
I agree with that, man. And I think we really all enjoyed the cricket thing. And I think we're all going to most definitely enjoy season 16. Literally going to be here in a couple days as we're recording this. We cannot fucking wait for it. We will be covering all of season 16 with new episodes dropping every Monday. Sorry, we'd like to get them out sooner, but not all of us get to work for Wolf Cola and make our own schedules.
We wish we did, though. And hey, Mills. Easy on those employees of Frank's Fluids, okay? It's been a rough fiscal year. The market's tough. Thank you guys for checking out A Night Pod Cometh. We love literally everything about Sunny, especially interacting with other Sunny fans. We do it for you. Any thoughts or predictions for the upcoming season? I hope you got them. If you do, let us know. Hit us up in the comment section of this YouTube video or on our social medias. We're just simply at Night Pod Cometh. That's right. We're just at Night Pod Cometh.
Find us wherever you get your pods, on YouTube, again, on the social medias, at Night Pod Cometh. Don't forget the flaps. Follow, like, and please subscribe. Helps other people find the show. We appreciate it. You had fun. Give us that thumb. This is Ben the Night Pod Cometh. I'm Magnum Mills. He's Jamie G. That's a Soupdeucer. Thank you again for checking us out and being a fighter for the Night Pod Cometh.
Whoa!
And, you know, right before we leave here, guys, as long as you don't mind, I'm going to go smoke some PCP in the bathroom, man. Is that cool?